the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today is Red Wednesday. We join the Universal Church in praying for persecuted Christians all over the world. We pray for the protection of those who profess their faith in Christ, because even now, in many parts of the world, people are killed simply because they are disciples of Christ. Let us also pray for their oppressors, that they may be converted and do the right thing. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us humbly ask God's pardon and mercy, because many times we too are instruments of persecution. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light and hope to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in your inscrutable providence will that the Church be united to the sufferings of your Son, grant, we pray, to your faithful who suffer for your name's sake a spirit of patience and charity, that they may be found true and faithful witnesses to the promises you have made. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw in heaven another sign, great and awe-inspiring. Seven angels with the seven last plagues, for through them God's fury is accomplished. Then I saw something like a sea of glass mingled with fire. On the sea of glass were standing those who had won the victory over the beasts, and its image and the number that signified its name. They were holding God's harps, and they sang the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb. Great and wonderful are your works, Lord God Almighty. Just and true are your ways, O King of the nations. Who will not fear you, Lord, or glorify your name? For you alone are holy. All the nations will come and worship before you, for your righteous acts have been revealed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Great and wonderful are all your works, Lord, mighty God.
Great and wonderful are all your works, Lord, mighty God.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm.
Great and wonderful are all your works, Lord, mighty God.
The Lord has made his salvation known in the sight of the nations. He has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel.
Great and wonderful are all your works, Lord, mighty God.
Let the sea and what fills it resound, the world and those who dwell in it. Let the rivers clap their hands, the mountains shout with them for joy.
Great and wonderful are all your works, Lord, mighty God.
Before the Lord, for he comes to rule the earth, he will rule the world with justice and the peoples with equity.
Great and wonderful are all your works, Lord, mighty God. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowd, "They will seize and persecute you. They will hand you over to the synagogues and to prisons, and they will have you led before kings and governors because of my name. It will lead to your giving testimony. Remember, you are not to prepare your defense beforehand, for I myself shall give you a wisdom in speaking that all your adversaries will be powerless to resist or refute. You will even be handed over by parents, brothers, relatives, and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but not a hair on your head will be destroyed. By your perseverance, you will secure your lives." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning. Red is the color of blood. Red is the color of martyrs who shed their blood because they are disciples. Today, we are praying for those who have given up their lives in following Christ. Today, we are praying for those persecuted Christians. And when I say Christians, it does not cover only Catholics. There are Coptics from Egypt who were killed by ISIS several years ago, and their only sin was that they were Christians. There are members of the Anglican Church or Episcopalian Church who are also victims of persecution. Today, we pray for them. But my question is, why are Christians persecuted? Why are Christians persecuted? I can think of at least three reasons. Number one, because they do the right thing. They do the right thing. They do what is expected of them as human beings. They love their neighbor. They love their enemies. They do charity work, even to those who are not capable of giving back. They do the right things, and those who are doing the wrong things will necessarily hate them. And that is our experience. In a workplace, for example, you are trying to come on time. You try to be prompt. If the time starts at 8, even 5 minutes before 8, you have already bundled in. And you leave on time. And you do the right thing during those times that you are paid. And there are some workmates who are not doing those things. And they will think of you as nagpapalakas yan eh. Gusto lang niya ma-promote. If you are doing the right things, you will also be persecuted because there are people who are not doing the right things and they will hate you. So that's the first. The second is Christians are persecuted because they stand for the truth. They don't spread fake news. They see and say what they see, the truth. And that in several years now, the truth has been the casualty. People are deceived. People are fooled because falsehoods were spread. Marami ang mga naloloko sa social media dahil maraming nakakalat na mga fake news. A Christian who is worthy of his name as a Christian should be standing by the truth. Bawal sa Kristiyano ang sinungaling. Bawal sa Kristiyano ang sinungaling. But be ready. When you speak for the truth, you will be persecuted by people who are living in lies. Mahirap magsalita ng totoo, pinapatay. Pero uulitin ko, walang Kristiyanong sinungaling. And finally, no one, no disciple can be greater than his master. In the gospel, Jesus warned his disciples, they will seize and persecute you. But this thing will also happen to Jesus. He will die a violent death. He would be subjected to persecution. And so, if the master has gone through persecution and died violently, do not be surprised if you as a disciple will experience the same. Because no disciple is greater than his master. So those are some of the reasons why Christians, even now, are being persecuted. They do the right thing. They stand for the truth. And that's part of being a disciple of Christ who was persecuted himself. But towards the end of the gospel, there is a kind of light at the end of the tunnel. Jesus assures those persecuted Christians of eternal life, by your perseverance, you will secure your lives. Now, Jesus is not speaking here of a physical life. Namatay na nga eh. No? What life can be secured if you have been killed already? What is this life that is promised to a Christian who remains faithful until the end? Eternal life. Buhay na walang hanggan. Ang naghihintay sa isang alagad na tapat hanggang kamatayan. As we continue to pray for persecuted Christians, perhaps we should examine ourselves also. Am I instrument of persecution too? Baka ipinagdarasal natin yung inuusig ng mga Kristiyano, pero nagiging taga-usig din tayo kuminsan. Let us pray for one another that if God will merit us to experience persecution, let us pray that we may be steadfast until the end. And let us pray that we will not be instruments of persecution. Amen.
Please stand.
The world and its people belong to God. Let us entrust ourselves to Him and believe and hope in God's protection. To every petition, our response would be, Lord, keep us in your care.
Lord, keep us in your care.
That the church may look at the future with faith and hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, keep us in your care.
That through our acts of kindness, the despised, the rejected, or unloved in our society may experience God's care in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, keep us in your care.
That we may have firm confidence in Jesus, who opens our eyes to the beauty of God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, keep us in your care.
That the sick and the suffering may see and feel God's healing presence in those who care for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, keep us in your care.
That perpetual light and grace be granted upon our deceased relatives and friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, keep us in your care.
Father in heaven, fill us with your love and dispel the darkness from our lives so that we may walk in the light of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Receive, we ask, O Lord, the prayers and sacrificial gifts we offer in humility, and grant that those who suffer persecution for their faithful service to you may rejoice to be united to the sacrifice of Christ your Son, and may know that their names are written in heaven among the company of the elect, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all of the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray.
Please stand.
By the power of this sacrament, O Lord, confirm your servants in the truth, and grant to your faithful who suffer tribulation that as they follow your Son in bearing their cross, they may, in every trial, glory in the name of Christian, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, it's Wednesday again, and I would like to invite you to join us in our weekly Wednesday Family Rosary. And tonight at 9 p.m., the Rosary will be hosted by the community of the National Shrine and Parish of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal in Muntinlupa City. So today also is traditionally the Feast of the Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. That's why we have in front of us the image of the Medalla Milagrosa, and the image that arrived yesterday will be staying here until tomorrow. So before the image, you may pray the rosary, you may tell the Blessed Mother your intentions, your needs, not only your needs, but the needs of other people. And let's see if there will be miracles that will be given to you. God may surprise you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.